This is KWTX News 10.
We begin with an update on a Central Texas soldier. He spent a decade behind bars at Leavenworth for war crimes he says he didn't commit. The Army Clemency and Parole Board today announced that First Sergeant John Hatley will be paroled. Gordon Collier joins us now on why this isn't all good news. Gordon.
Well, Tara, it certainly is good news that Sergeant Hatley will be getting out of Leavenworth, but the parole board set his release date, forget this, October of next year. You'll remember Hatley was convicted in a military court of the murder of four Iraqi detainees, despite the fact there was no physical evidence to support the charges. Last week, he went before the Army Board of Clemency and Parole for the fourth time. Everything looked promising, and his family was hoping that he would be home in time for the holidays.
The turkey is going to be cold because I really expected him to be out in by Thanksgiving.
The family doesn't want to appear unappreciative, quite the opposite. They're very grateful to the coalition of congressmen who testified on his behalf before the parole board last week. But news that their soldier will have to spend another year behind bars is not exactly what they wanted to hear. And Sergeant Hatley told his dad he wasn't surprised by the bittersweet news.
And he said, I have to admit, it don't surprise me. I've been here enough times and went through it that you can almost predict what they're going to do.
Does he have any clue why they would extend this for another year?
Not unless it looks bad on the military to let an innocent man out.
Central Texas Congressman Bill Flores and East Texas Congressman Louis Gohmert were part of the coalition that testified on his behalf. The family has been in contact with them, and the congressmen are vowing to continue to fight for an earlier release date.
I don't think you insult our congressman this way and think you get by with it. Because I take this as an insult to our lawmakers. Because you think they would lay their names on the dotted page for somebody that, if they didn't have confidence that person could live up to their expectation, I think his life shows it.
The congressional delegation known as the Justice for Warriors Coalition says they will continue to reach out to President Trump for a possible presidential pardon. Meanwhile, the family finds some comfort in knowing that a year from now, Sergeant Hatley will be home.